from the Mercy One Studio.
Be not afraid. Jesus is on the way to encounter you. Join Father Fabian Moncada every Tuesday at 9 a.m. on Iowa Catholic Radio. Also tune in Sundays at 10:30 a.m. for Be Not Afraid in Spanish. Now, hear the good news and be not afraid.
Be Not Afraid is underwritten by Associated Ophthalmologists and Dream Dirt, Farm Real Estate and Auction Services.
Good morning. Welcome to Be Not Afraid. Father PJ, good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Let us begin in the name of the Father, and in the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God of justice, in your wisdom you create all people in your image, without the exception. Through your goodness, open our eyes to see the dignity, beauty, and worth of every human being. Open our minds to understand that all your children are brothers and sisters in the same human family. Open our hearts to repent of racist attitudes, behaviors, and speech which demean others. Open our ears to hear the cries of those wounded by racial discrimination and their passionate appeals for change. Strengthen our resolve to make amends for past injustice and to right the wrongs of history. And fill us with courage that we might seek to heal wounds, build bridges, forgive and be forgiven, and establish peace and equality for all in our communities. In Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Well, today we have a very interesting program to talking about these current circumstances in our life in terms of this kind of discrimination, racism, but especially I like to use the word excluding human being. So, Father, today we are focused on the Catholic social teaching and racism as well. So basically, the moral judgment on racism. Consideration of racism is grounded in fundamental scriptural beliefs. Equal dignity of all people, created in God's image, and Christ's redemption of all. In fact, the catechisms of the Catholic Church spell this out. The equality of men rests essentially on their dignity as persons and the rights that flow from it. Every form of social or cultural discrimination in fundamental personal rights on the grounds of sex, race, color, social condition, language, or religion must be curbed and eradicated as incompatible with God's design. Moral judgment and racism based on equality are consistent. Any theory or form whatsoever of racism and racial discrimination, it's morally unacceptable. In terms of theology, Father, how we can understand the word unacceptable in terms of racism as well?
Right. You know, the Church's teaching as regards race and racism is first grounded in the natural law. So it's not first and foremost a divinely revealed truth, but a truth revealed in nature itself. And it's very telling, right, that even historically, when peoples have been oppressed in ways that seem to deny their fundamental humanity, the deniers, the oppressors, right, clearly recognize the human quality of the persons that they're subjugating, and that they're not simply sort of animals, right? So the chattel slavery that existed in the United States, which was one of the most horrendous that's ever been known, right? The people were treated like cattle, but they clearly weren't, right? Because they were like talking and walking and had a culture and stories, which like cows don't, right? There's no cow cathedrals. And so the natural law, which is written into the heart of every person and revealed in nature itself, shows that human persons have a purpose. And their purpose isn't simply to do unpaid labor for other persons.
Excellent.
This is sort of heightened in Revelation, in that because we know that human beings have been made in the image and likeness of God, and because we know in Christ Jesus all share in the common redemption of humanity, the subjugation of other persons by Christians is an especially grievous crime that really calls out to heaven for justice. Of all the people that should know better in the whole history of the world, Christians should know better than anyone why it's wrong to oppress people.
Wow. USCCB defined beautifully, said, racism is not merely one sin among many. It is a radical evil dividing the human family. Then Jesus tells us the Good Samaritan story, one of his three great parables, to answer, who is my neighbor? And Father, in this time that we have a lot of turmoil circumstances with this pandemic, plus these very unacceptable events about racial confrontations, who is my neighbor? How we can understand who is my neighbor under these kind of circumstances?
So everyone.
Absolutely.
And if you want like a quick and easy test to figure out whether or not you're treating somebody as a neighbor, think about the person that makes you craziest, whether that person's in your life or on TV or in the newspapers or whatever. Think about the groups of people that make you craziest, that trigger you and set you off and make you yell and scream and complain. If you couldn't take care of them the way that the Good Samaritan takes care of the poor man beset by robbers, you're not where you need to be yet.
Remember that we are Be Not Afraid, Iowa Catholic Radio.
Thank you, Dream Dirt Farm Real Estate and Auction, for your support of Iowa Catholic Radio and Be Not Afraid. Dream Dirt Farm Real Estate and Auction is a licensed, accredited, and experienced farm brokerage and auction company. Learn more at dreamdirt.com, including their online auction house, Farm Bid, at bid.dreamdirt.com. Dream Dirt Farm and Equipment Auction Services, Farm Auctions Done Right.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio and John Leonetti in the Morning is provided by Blessman International. The coronavirus has impacted lives in Iowa and around the world. This is especially true in rural South Africa, where COVID-19 restrictions have led to vulnerable children being hospitalized due to starvation. To combat this hunger, Blessman International now offers a program called One Child at a Time. You can sponsor a child in South Africa for $1 a day. Learn more at blessmaninternational.org. blessmaninternational.org.
Is it time for a new roof? Then it could be time for you to get to know Bell Construction. Bell Construction is a roofing company entering its 30th year of business. They specialize in residential re-roofs, light commercial jobs, and have the experience to meet all of your roofing needs with personal service. With Bell Construction, the owner will come to your home or place of business in person to inspect and ensure the quality of work that you deserve. They pride themselves in working with you on a personal basis and making sure you are satisfied. Bell Construction, 515-963-4494.
Thank you, Big Red Q Quick Print, for underwriting the Sports Report. Family owned and operated since 1980, Big Red Q Quick Print is a full service print shop ready to help you with all your printing needs with speed and accuracy. Forms, manuals, brochures, letterhead, envelopes, business cards, custom invitations, design, and bindery. Big Red Q Quick Print, located across from Merle Hay Mall, online at bigredq-desmoines.com. Big Red Q Quick Print. We make printing easy.
What is the best gift ever? Giving a Catholic education is at the top of my list. Your contribution to CTO helps families send their children to our Catholic schools who otherwise could not afford it. In giving to CTO, you receive the best tax credits ever. Pledge or donate online at ctoiowa.org. The bottom line, it's for the kids and their future.
Welcome back to Be Not Afraid, Father PJ, Father Fabian, talking this morning about racism. Father, how many faces have this racism in our culture? It's not only to excluding for certain participation of the people, also it's completely lack to see the face of God in people in terms of differences of culture and language, also socioeconomic condition as well, you know?
You know, I think a good kind of moral test to see where my prejudices lie is to ask myself who, like what person or what groups am I willing to give the benefit of the doubt to? Okay. So when a person says or does something that otherwise I find bothersome, is my first move to try and find a reasonable explanation for why they did this out of charity to try and presume the best? Or is it to blame and excoriate and like make bad out of, right? And so long as I have people that I'm not willing to presume the good over, I still have moral work to do. I still have growth to do. So that the face of racism, right, is both personal and institutional. It's both individual and systemic. There are ways in which individuals and persons and groups and whole societies can wind up working against individuals and groups and whole other societies.
Saint John Paul II reminds us in a beautiful reflection about these kind of evil circumstances like racism. Saint John Paul II maintained a fourfold personal responsibility for social evils: the very personal sins of those who cause or support evil or who exploit it, of those who are in a position to avoid, eliminate, or at least limit certain social evils, but who fail to do so out of laziness, fear, or the conspiracy of silence through secret complicity or indifference of those who take refuge in the supposed impossibility of changing the world, and also of those who sidestep the effort and sacrifice required, producing spacious reasons of a higher order. Sometimes we are very radical in our intellectual interpretation about human beings. Sometimes we lost the capacity to see this beautiful creation that is capable to afford all the human being condition, you know?
Right. I mean, all St. John Paul II is really doing is taking very classic Catholic moral theory and applying it to the problem of what today we might call systemic or societal prejudice, right? Mm-hmm. So we can be complicit in the sin of racial or other prejudice by being actual active supporters or exploiters ourselves, so engaging in objectively clear sort of racist acts ourselves, or through becoming a kind of accessory through our complicity or indifference, that we wind up sort of saying, well, yeah, this is a problem, but there's not much I can do about it, or I might not do it myself, but I don't work against it because I get some kind of good out of it, or through a kind of fatalistic acceptance. There's nothing I can do to fix this. Society's got to fix it itself. I'm just one guy, so I don't have to say or do anything different. Or through what he calls consecration of the status quo, which is where we're so addicted to a system and the way the system works that rather than address the injustice in the system, we simply, as he says, consecrate or sort of hallow the human cost as sort of the price of doing business.
And at the same time, came to my mind that probably one of the great gasoline that moving these racism and excluded process is pride, you know, very egocentric. I am the power, I am the person who can make a justice. You know, this human being is a lot of pride. That is a very remarkable manner how this human being is equal, create the same image as God's creation, you know?
Right. Pride, greed, and envy are really the three capital sins that lie at the root of racism and most all prejudice. And, you know, I preached on this last Sunday, on Trinity Sunday, on the question of racial equality. And I said the persons of the Trinity offer us the model for how we're meant to relate to other persons. The Father is not jealous of the Son, and the Son is not jealous of the Spirit, and neither are the others jealous of one another. They don't have to prove anything. They don't have to be not you in order to be me, so like to highlight. What makes me different in a way is to make me opposed. Rather, they complement and fulfill one another. The Father is only Father in light of relation to the Son, and the Son only Son in light of relation to the Father. You couldn't be one without the other. And so, and the Spirit, right, is this new person that is the person that is given life by that relationship. We tend, however, to set ourselves in opposition to one another. I know who I am because I'm not you. Absolutely. I know I'm white because I'm not Colombian, right?
Unfortunately. I mean,
but that's the way we wind up doing it. And all that does is create conflict and discord, diminishes the dignity of the other, refuses to recognize the image of God in the other, as opposed to celebrating and delighting in the otherness of the other, and then allowing them to do so in me.
Absolutely. Remember that we are, and be not afraid, we're talking about resistance. Father PJ, Father Fabian, Iowa Catholic Radio.
Thank you to Mercy College of Health Sciences, downtown Des Moines, for underwriting our show, The Uncommon Good, with me, Bo Bonner.
And I'm Bud Marr. A degree from Mercy College provides endless possibilities. Students have access to patients with complex medical conditions, state-of-the-art medical facilities, highly motivated healthcare professionals, and classroom professors that transform them into servant leaders.
You can start the programs in fall, spring, or summer. There are endless possibilities available online at mchs.edu/kwky.
Programming support for Catholic Women Now is provided by Iowa's injury attorney, Fred Haas. For over 30 years, Fred Haas has helped injured Iowans recover financial, physical, and emotional losses from car, truck, and motorcycle accidents, work-related injuries, and injuries due to negligence. Most importantly, providing the professional, personal, and responsive legal counsel that everyone deserves. Fred Double D, Haas Double A, the Des Moines Law Offices of Fred Haas. While we have time, let us do good.
Support for Iowa Catholic Radio's broadcast of Dowling Catholic Sports and Activities is provided by Kemin, a global ingredient manufacturer using science to transform the quality of life for 80% of the world. Kemin is on the leading edge of molecular science, manufacturing more than 500 specialty ingredients for the human and animal health and nutrition, pet food, aquaculture, nutraceutical, food technologies, crop technologies, and textile industries. Kemin strives to sustainably transform the quality of life every day for 80% of the world with their products and services. Kemin, using science to transform the world. Online at Kemin.com.
Since 1924, St. Vincent de Paul has been helping those less fortunate work towards self-sufficiency. Last year, St. Vincent de Paul helped over 20,000 individuals with food, clothing, and shelter, while also offering classes in financial literacy, high school completion, career readiness, and prisoner reentry. SVDPDSM.org, 515-282-8327. Shop, donate, volunteer, serve. This message was brought to you by Homemakers Furniture.
Welcome back to Be Not Afraid, and this coming 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time, we have an amazing response from the Sunday's Gospel about these circumstances of racism. So first of all, the Gospel of Matthew describes, "Fear not, you are of more value than many sparrows." From the Gospel of Matthew chapter 10, verses 26 to 33, Jesus said to the 12, "Fear no one. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What that I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet no one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my heavenly Father." Very providential gospel for this coming Sunday, according to our topic today, Father.
Absolutely. You know, the fundamental error of racism, cultural oppression, any of it, right, is to fail to see the value in the other, and to fail to see the value in the other as other, right? So that every other person you meet, C.S. Lewis says this, right? He says, every person you meet walking down the street is destined to spend eternity with the angels in heaven or the devils in hell. Every person you meet has an eternal destiny, is that kind of important. And yet most of us pass by most of the people that we see blithely as though they're entirely unimportant.
Godly fear, reverence, and respect for God's ways produce wisdom and right judgment. What is godly fear? It's it is reverence for the one who made us in love and who sustained us in mercy and kindness. Wow.
So we should see in the face of every creature, both rational human creatures and even, you know, the birds of the air and the beasts of the field, plants of the earth, we should see the fingerprint of the Creator. But in the human person especially, we should see the image of the God who made us and of the God who redeemed us to bring us to heaven to be with him forever.
Beautiful. Proclaim boldly what no earthly power can destroy, the cross and resurrection of Jesus Christ. This is a temporal life. Sometimes it's very hard to understand why the people wasting a lot of time, energy, and a lot of forces to try to keep these just temporal moments and avoid the encounter with eternal life with our Savior and Redeemer. When Jesus proclaimed the kingdom of God, he met opposition and hostility from those who refused to believe in him.
Yeah, it's critically important, right? The value in our temporal life comes as a result of the value of the eternal life and not the other way around. But seen rightly, you know, once we've grasped the value of eternal life, then there's all the more reason to strive for justice in the world so that our temporal lives reflect our eternal lives.
How can I understand divine justice about human justice when we're talking about racism, Father?
So, you know, justice fundamentally is the virtue by which we give to each their due. Of course, in one sense, divine justice demands damnation for everyone, right? Because all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But in Christ Jesus, the possibility of redemption lies open for all people, which is why the apostle says there's no longer slave or free, Jew or Greek, man or woman. We would add, you know, black, white, brown, yellow, right? There's those distinctions aren't what bind us anymore. What binds us is our redemption in Christ. And because of that common redemption and what it promises, then we who are followers of Jesus, we who strive to make his life and will known on earth, we have to work for racial justice, societal justice, civil justice, right? For everybody. Not as a sort of add-on to the gospel, but as its logical consequence, and in order to create a society in which it's easiest for all people to be good.
It's clear, fear not, you are more value than many sparrows. It's very eloquent, this piece of the gospel, to enlighten us how important, unique, and preference from God's love and mercy we are. So also it's an invitation to looking forward to healing ourselves and also our relationship one to another. This example of racism is completely evil present in this world. We are calling to living together as community, as the sons and daughters of God, that growing together in terms of faith to encounter Jesus from this temporal life to the eternal life in his kingdom that endures forever. We are approaching our ending program. Father, I'd like to use one beautiful Catholic prayer to conclude, and then if you are willing to give us your blessing, will be appreciated. Jesus, our brother, you reveal God through your wise words and loving deeds, and we encounter you still today in the faces of those whom society has pushed to the margins. Guide us through the love you revealed to establish the justice you proclaim, that all peoples might dwell in harmony and peace, united by the one love that binds us to each other and to you. Amen.
May the God who has so wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and even more wonderfully restored it grant that all the nations of the earth should be drawn unto himself and all peoples should know justice and peace. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Be not afraid, Iowa Catholic Radio. God bless you.
Be not afraid. Jesus is on the way to encounter you. Join Father Fabian Moncada every Tuesday at 9 a.m. on Iowa Catholic Radio. Also tune in Sundays at 10:30 a.m. for Be Not Afraid in Spanish. Now, hear the good news and be not afraid.
Be Not Afraid is underwritten by Associated Ophthalmologists and Dream Dirt, Farm Real Estate and Auction Services.